During the reign of Henry VIII, thousands of people were executed for a number of different reasons. We remember Henry for his tyrannical reign and how he changed England forever, but also the fact he had six wives, two of which he executed inside the walls of the Tower of London. Tudor England was a bloody time, in which executions and capital punishment was common in an attempt to deter people from offending inside the kingdom. But as Henry reigned between 1509 and 1547, scores of people were killed, and many of these people were incredibly high profile, and some were his closest friends. Today we're going to look at how many people did Henry VIII execute, to investigate whether his reputation as a brutal and feared ruler is deserved, or whether in fact it was standard and normal at the time for this to happen. So join us today as we look at the killer king, Henry VIII, and remember to support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. When King Henry VIII came onto the throne on the 22nd of April 1509, there were great hopes for his reign. His father, Henry VII, had defeated the Yorkists during the Wars of the Roses and united the two warring factions under the Tudor Rose. Much hope remained with Henry VIII's reign, and it was hoped for a long and peaceful one for the new king. However, that's far from what the country got. During Henry's 36 years of rule, it's been estimated that around 57,000 people were executed across the country for a number of different reasons. Some historians place the number of people killed at around 70,000, which is a colossal amount of people. If we consider that the number of total executions to have been around 70,000, this equates to around 2.6% of the population of Henry's kingdom. This meant that almost 1 in 30 people at the start of the reign would meet their bloody end in some form of execution, which itself is incredibly shocking. However, why were these people killed, and why were so many people executed at the behest of the king? There were a number of reasons why these people were killed, and it wasn't just high profile people who were executed. However, some of the first victims of the king were Edmund Dudley and Robert Empson, killed in Henry's first year of his reign. These two men had been rather unpopular and members of his father's government, and their execution set a precedent for the young king's reign, and he wished to be liked by court and country, and by ridding the country of these two disliked men, his popularity rose. Empson and Dudley were seen as the ones responsible for the high taxes Henry VII placed on the country. However, things did get much more severe during Henry VIII's reign. There were a number of key reasons why Henry ordered executions, or why executions occurred across England at the time. Now, the most famous executions were those of royalty, and even the aristocracy who Henry saw as a threat. These were the executions that Henry himself personally ordered, or had his friends such as Oliver Cromwell organise for him. One family that would be decimated by Henry was the Boleyns, and although we consider the most famous Boleyn to be Henry's second wife Anne, he also ordered the executions of her brother and her brother's wife later in life. It is also for the execution of Catherine Howard, the king's fifth wife, that we remember Henry, with Catherine being just a teenage girl, much younger than the grotesque king, when she was beheaded inside the walls of the Tower of London. Henry often used an act of attainder to sentence people such as Catherine Howard to death without any formal trial, and this allowed him to execute anyone with no opposition. It wasn't just wives that Henry killed, he also executed a number of his close friends and allies. However, both the fate of Thomas More and Thomas Cromwell is linked into the king's failed love life. Sir Thomas More and Cromwell were both very close to the king, especially Cromwell, who helped to organise the dissolution of the monasteries, which made the king incredibly rich, with Cromwell's agents seizing vast riches from the religious buildings and orders. These were then transported straight into the royal coffers, and because of this, Cromwell was incredibly liked by the king. But even he would be executed, and was sentenced to death by an act of attainder, having been accused of treason. Treason was the most serious offence in Tudor England, and it's often a crime that met the death penalty. Treason ranged from actively plotting to assassinate the monarch, to quietly speaking ill against the king. It would be treason that many of those remembered who were killed during his reign were found guilty of. For example, Anne Boleyn was found guilty of treason and was accused of even plotting to kill her husband. Treason varied in its definition, and for this thousands were executed. Even disagreeing with the king on a matter of policy would result in someone being brought to Tower Hill to be beheaded. One of the biggest protests against the reign of Henry VIII was the Pilgrimage of Grace, which was led by the lawyer Robert Aske. It rose up in Yorkshire and spread quickly across the north to different counties, and there were mass protests against the king. It was instigated by a poor harvest in 1535, and food prices rose, but also the rebels were angry with Henry's changes to the church, and the fact that the poor were unable to turn to the dissolved monasteries for food, shelter and support. The rebellion combined religious and political issues, and Robert Aske assembled a crowd of around 30,000 angry people at York. The rebellion was eventually put down, however it resulted in a huge amount of executions, many in bloody fashion, such as Robert Aske, who was hanged in chains from the walls of Clifford's Tower in York. Another victim in a sense of the pilgrimage was Margaret Pole, the Countess of Salisbury, who was 67 when she was beheaded inside the Tower of London. She was linked to the pilgrimage through her son, however her execution was incredibly botched. Pole's death was incredibly brutal, and it's considered that when Henry ordered her execution, he killed a remaining member of the Plantagenet dynasty, who was a legitimate rival to Henry's throne. One of the strangest treason executions of Henry's reign occurred to Mabel Brigg, a woman accused of witchcraft, who was alleged to have performed a black fast predicting the death of Henry VIII and his advisers. One of the biggest causes of the thousands of executions, however, was the English Reformation, which began when Henry split from the Catholic Church to secure a divorce from his first wife Catherine of Aragon. Henry was branded the supreme head of the Church of England and passed the Act of Supremacy, in which all members of the clergy had to swear support and accept Henry in this position. Because of the sanctity of many of those religious people, they refused to accept the change and ultimately faced the ultimate punishment. In particular, one group was a House of Carthusian monks in London, and their charter house was decimated when the Catholic order refused to accept the king as the head of the church, preferring the Pope. The London Charter House had dozens of its monks hacked to pieces, being hanged, drawn and quartered, beheaded, and many were even starved to death inside London prisons at the orders of Henry. Also, Bishop John Fisher was a rather well-celebrated Catholic bishop who refused to accept the king as the head of the church, and he even supported Henry's first wife, Catherine of Aragon. Because of this, he was brutally beheaded on Tower Hill, much to the dismay of many people across London. Failing to accept the king's religious reforms also plunged dozens of abbots and priests in danger, and in particular the abbots of Glastonbury Abbey and Woburn Abbey were executed in horrific manner. Religion was a big motivator in many of the king's punishments, and it was during his reign that Anne Askew, a Protestant martyr, was tortured inside the Tower of London on the rack and was then burned to death, being claimed to have been a heretic. A heretic was a religious criminal, and following Henry's religious changes, thousands were accused of this. Now, one of the other points to make is that many of the executions that occurred during the reign of Henry VIII were not in fact personally ordered by the king. They were more in keeping with the laws on capital punishment at the time in Tudor England. For serious crimes such as murder or arson, it was often likely that the defendant could find themselves taken into a town centre for a public execution that would take place inside of a town square. These events were big spectacles too, and would always attract a huge crowd. So during the reign of Henry VIII, it was a dangerous time to live. The fact dozens of thousands of people were executed in barbaric fashion during his reign shows us that Henry does deserve his notorious reputation. It wasn't just the executions of his wives that we should remember, it's all of those people who were executed in the name of religion and also treason as well. Henry VIII does deserve his horrific reputation, and is remembered as the most brutal king that England ever had to rule over it. Once again, thanks for watching. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. And once again, thank you so much for watching.